Creative movement in the jungle.
Let's dance!
Hi, I'm Danielle Solon, and I'm so excited to be here with you today. If you walk into my classroom, there's something you're going to hear kids say a lot.
I have ideas!
In our music program, we really value student ideas and giving kids opportunities to use their creativity. Today, our theme is creative movement, how we can improvise and create choreography to express our ideas in response to music. As a first step in creative movement for kids, it's great to have them explore a wide variety of locomotor and non-locomotor movements. This can happen throughout the year or in a single warm-up. Let's take a look.
And pose. Pose is different and strong every time. Ooh, I see an interesting one there. Okay, and let's see, how about something that has rotation or turning? Turn. And freeze. How about something that has very highs or very lows? Change your level more. And highs and lows. And freeze. Something where you're going backwards, but be careful. Look out where you're going. And backwards movements. Maybe you're skipping backwards, running backwards, stepping, marching backwards. And freeze. That's right. We don't always have to go forward. How about a move that has some angles, almost robotic, and angular movement. And freeze. Now, the opposite of that, like snaky, slinky movement. Snaky, slinky movement. And freeze.
Now, our work in creative movement will begin. Today, we'll be listening to an intriguing piece of music by Phillip Glass, called Japurá River. And to introduce this music, I'd like to start off with a bit of a story. It's Monday morning, and when I came into my classroom this morning, I noticed something was a little different. I looked around, and on my desk, here's what I found. Have you ever seen one of these before? I think it's a kind of fruit. In fact, I've seen this kind of fruit before. The last time I saw it was when I was in South America in the jungle. I was thinking about that trip, and that evening when I went home, I read my daughter one of my favorite books, Where the Wild Things Are. Now, you've probably read this book. At the beginning of this book, Max makes his mother cross and gets told to go to bed without his supper. Well, when Max is alone in his room, that very night, a forest grew and grew and grew until a ceiling hung with vines and the walls became the world all around him. Well, in this classroom, which is now a jungle, we're going to imagine that passion fruit are hanging from branches in the trees. What kind of animals can you imagine might swing from branch to branch to grab this fruit and have them for its dinner? That's right, monkeys. So now we're going to do a movement sequence where we're imagining we're monkeys who swing from branch to branch, reach up, grab fruit from the tree, and land gracefully on their feet.
A section, choreography.
Reach, reach. Leap and land, reach, reach, leap and land.
That was the A section of the music. There are four phrases, and whenever we hear music that sounds like that, we're going to imagine we're those monkeys swinging from vine to vine, and we'll do that same choreography.
B section, we improvise.
Now we will begin the B section of the movement. And to do this part, we're going to improvise and show our ideas for creative movement. But first, let's talk about predator and prey. The jungle all around us is full of predator and prey, and I want us to think about how the prey might move. If you're a small creature who is worried about getting hunted, here's how you might move in the jungle. If you're a prey, then you have to try to stay as hidden as possible from the predators. Meanwhile, you have to go out and get your food. In our music for the B section, we will have 8-beat phrases. For the first half of the phrase, we're gonna move in a sneaky, creative way. And then for the last half of the phrase, we're gonna freeze in an interesting pose that's special to you and different every time. Move, sneak, scamper, and freeze. Remember that you can try out all the different types of movement that you've practiced in your physical education classes, in music, or at home. While you're moving around the room, you can, what are some ideas?
Shake, gallop,
skip,
creep,
sneak,
turn,
leap,
slither,
crawl,
hide,
run,
slide.
We create!
Watching second grade students perform Japurá River. But first, I'd like to point out a few top tips for setting students up for success. Number one, pick a great piece of music that inspires you. When you hear it, you'll know it. A piece of music that has a sense of intrigue or mystery or just kindles that sense of expression, something that students will respond to. Two, choose music with clear A and B themes that repeat throughout the music. That way, students have the chance to do learned choreography for the A section and creative improvisation for the B section. Three, give kids a role to play or tell a story or set up a scene so that kids have something to spark their imagination for their creative movement. Now let's watch the kids. The students you've been seeing in this presentation are second graders at my school. They are not over rehearsed or polished. They came in for one previous 30-minute class in which they got to listen for the first time to Japurá River and explore the choreography and creative movement. Then they came in today and we said, let's film. They did a great job, they're having fun, and I hope you enjoy watching them. Feel free to dance along.
Japurá River by Phillip Glass.
Thank you.
Creative movement is super fun for kids, and it's also a great learning opportunity, especially when the teacher or other peers give feedback. Let's take a look now at a few pairs of partners giving each other feedback on their movement.
Move, 2, 3, 4, and freeze, 2, 3, 4. Move, 2, 3, 4, and freeze, 2, 3, 4. Okay, can you keep your pose while you get your feedback? Keep your pose. Okay, Laurent, come over to your partner and can you give her some feedback? You're with Kaylong, that's right.
I like your freeze movement.
What do you like about it specifically?
Like you freeze like different movements.
You mean different levels?
Yeah.
Here you go. Move, 2, 3, 4, and freeze, 2, 3, 4. Move, 2, 3, 4, and freeze, 2, 3, 4. Okay, keep your pose while your partner comes and gives you feedback. Kaylong, can you give feedback first?
I like the first time your pose is like your ice skating.
Ah, so it really caught your imagination?
Ice skating. We're doing all from here.
Once students are in love with this piece of music and familiar with the structure, you can return to it throughout the year, but change it up. A great way to change it up is to keep introducing new creative improvisational movement games for all the B sections of the piece. My students' favorite movement game ever, and this is one you'll definitely want to try out when students can get a little bit closer and more interactive with their bodies. It's called Jigsaw, otherwise known as positive negative space. And it makes for a fantastic B section for Japurá River. Here's how you play Jigsaw. One partner makes a shape, and the other partner finds a way to fit in and around that shape. Now, my fantastic teaching partner, Laura Lorentzen, and I will demonstrate how to do Japurá River using choreography for the A section and the game Jigsaw for all of the B sections. We've performed it like this for audiences and concerts, and it's really, really fun to watch and really, really fun to perform for the kids. Here today to explore creative movement. Kids absolutely love these movement games and they adore the piece Japurá River. With its haunting minimalism and its bouncy pulse, they can't get enough and enjoy listening to it and moving to it time and time again. From this presentation, I hope you've gotten some ideas for how to explore creative movement with your students, alone or with partners, now and in the future. Before going today, I'd like to give a big thank you to the SongWorks Educators Association, and also to my two great mentors for creative movement, Krista Coogan and Estevao Marques. In fact, Estevao is the one who I got the idea from to use this piece of music for creative movement. So thank you, Estevao. And thank you to all of you for being here with me today. Bye.